The epic Superman Unchained saga comes to a close in issue 9. Last year, we got to sit in on the very first creative meeting between Jim Lee and Scott Snyder about designing the cover for this climactic final issue.
So issue 9, I got to draw this cover. I think we're going to do this wraparound, which is something we've been wanting to do for a while. You know, Wraith's going to be in the middle of Superman, obviously. Do you have any kind of hooks that you can think of?
He basically beats him with the truth. And so what happens is he goes back to the fortress and there's a fleet coming and all of them are almost as powerful as Wraith. And Superman is all beaten up and he's like, I have to go try and at least fight them. I'm the only one that can go up there in time. And all of a sudden, Jimmy Olsen stumbles through the snow and he has the Lex watch on.
Right.
And inside of it is a syringe with the material that would have caused Wraith or him to sort of have the ability to solar charge to blow up. So Superman takes it and flies up into space to do it himself, is the idea. And he goes up, and I was going to have him along the way fight a ton of the ships that are ahead and bring in other superheroes if we want, you know, show the global scale of the attack.
Right.
My only worry about it was literally just the space that it would take to do all of that in one issue. If we do it and we take the extra space, the fleet could be on Earth and be attacking, and Superman shoots up and goes up to take on the ship. He'd be in a Kryptonian armor suit and all that kind of stuff, too, so we could
okay.
do that.
Well, I see that. There we go. The Kryptonian armor suit. That's something that would look great on the cover.
Yeah, he'd be a warrior, you know, like Wraith.
Right. You also mentioned other superheroes too, right? So I assume other members of the Justice League.
I mean, we'd have to go to almost 10 issues or something like that to fit it, I think. I mean, I'm all for going as crazy as
right.
you want, as always, you know?
No, I think that's a great way to go, and I would love to show it. I mean, that's something you can only do in Superman, right? I feel like it should not just be the end of the story. It should be the end of a story with imagery and things you've never seen before.
Jim Lee drew the cover, but another man, colorist Alex Sinclair, brought it to life. Here's how he brought the whole thing together.
When I work with Jim and Scott, I actually get the artboards. Scott lives 2 blocks away.
Nice.
So when he's done with the page, he drives it over, or I drive, depends on what part of the deadline we're on. But I get the actual artboard and scan it. I scan it into Photoshop, and then I just go with it. Either I'm doing the entire page, or I hire a person to do what's called flats. And it's basically selecting every item and filling it with a flat color. With no highlights, no shadows, it's just a flat color, and that's what we call them, flats. And then I'll start to add the affected lighting. Our process is pretty much become all digital now. When I first started, we were still doing paper guides and then coloring it digitally. Now it's just go straight to digital. The process has become a little more streamlined for us. It feels more artistic now, as
really?
Opposed to kind of just reinterpreting what someone else colored or what something you colored on paper, you're recoloring it on the computer.
Yeah.
Now we're skipping that step. So thanks to like the software like Adobe Photoshop, it's like I'm painting it with watercolors or oil paints or something like that. Working with someone like Jim, he's great because when he's drawing a page, he's already thinking of the inks and the colors too.
Yeah.
So he's just not focused on what he's doing. He's thinking of how it's going to affect the next few steps.
Well, and from talking with Jim, we know that sometimes he hides things. Does he call you up or email you and is like, hey, so I hid this here?
Like, I zoom in so much that I find that stuff. And I hide it a little bit more sometimes.
Yeah.
Lately, he's been hiding phrases and stuff like that. So, you know, if you see a crack on the wall, you might want to look closer.
Is there anything in an upcoming issue you can hint at for people to look for?
It's mostly in covers.
Okay.
Covers is where he hides his messages.
Have there been any books that have stood out to you in that whole career where you're like, this is the one that I'm the most proud of?
Probably it'd be easier to narrow it down by series. Hush is definitely on that top three list. It's on a lot of people's top three list. Blackest Night was hard to do, but I'm very proud of the work that came out in that book. Flashpoint was fun to work with Andy Kubert and Jeff Johns. And I'm actually really proud of the work that I've been doing on Green Lanterns since the New 52 came out.
Yeah.
I'm still on the book, it's been 3 years, and I haven't left because it's still fun.
How many books do you think you've worked on in the length of your career? Just a guesstimate.
You figure I do about 3 to 4 books a month, so 12 months in a year. I've been in the industry for about 21 years. You throw in some covers here and there, so yeah, I'm about to hit the 1,000 mark, I guess.
That's insane.
Yeah.
For more DC All Access, click one of the videos right over here, and make sure you guys subscribe to DC All Access so you don't miss out on any of the behind-the-scenes looks at how your favorite comics come together.